founder of Batch Cooking Club, and I am so excited to welcome you to today's cooking class. We are here live every Thursday featuring a recipe from our weekly meal prep membership that makes mealtime easier. So I am making our Italian marinated mushrooms. This is a very simple, easy recipe that adds so much flavor to your dishes, from antipasto platters to snack boards to casseroles. I love putting these in pasta casseroles, to salads and grain bowls and our kebabs, which we're featuring in this week's meal plan. This is such a flavorful recipe that adds a little something something to whatever you put them in. So before I get started, I want to shout out to our members, any of our members who are watching today. Thank you for tuning in live. Anyone who's not a member, thank you for taking time to join me in the kitchen, my favorite place to be. And welcome to anybody who's new to us. If you're new to us, Batch Cooking Club, like I said, is a plant-based meal prep membership that makes mealtime easier. We give you 4 dinner recipes a week, a prep plan to do on the weekend that speeds up your dinners during the week, a grocery list, and so much more. So I invite you to check us out at batchcookingclub.com. if you want to learn more. And I have a little special something going on this month. It is Children's Cancer Awareness Month. And then while I am talking, so you don't just look at me talking, I am going to clean the mushrooms. So I started to do that over here. I'm using cremini mushrooms for this recipe. You need 3 cups. I have about 2 cups here. And if you've never cleaned a mushroom or you're not sure, don't immerse them in water. Mushrooms are like sponges, they're little fungi. So if you put them in water, they absorb all the water and then you get soggy mushrooms. And you don't want soggy mushrooms, especially not for this recipe. So what I always do is I take a wet paper towel or a wet cloth, and I just look on the mushroom for where there's spots of dirt. I just lightly, you know, brush it off. And here, I'll show you one that's like dirt. So there's some dirt there. So I'm just lightly brushing it off like that. And I'm just gonna keep doing that. And then we're gonna slice the ends a little bit, trim them up a little just so they look a little prettier. So while I'm doing this and I'm finishing up our mushrooms, I wanna tell you about a very, very special fundraiser I have going on that's dear to my heart. When you join Batch Cooking Club this month for just $10, it's just $10 a month, you get every week 4 dinner recipes planned for you, a meal prep plan that tells you what to cook on the weekend to get all of this done, so dinner is like 15 to 30 minutes during the week. You get a grocery list every week with all the ingredients for all the recipes. You get a ingredient substitution guide updated weekly, so that if you have picky eaters, if you have non-plant-based eaters, you want to change up, adapt the recipe, we've got options for you. Let's see, what else you got? You've got the grocery list, you've got the meal plan, you've got the recipes. I think I covered it all. And you get private access to our Facebook group just for members, where we do lots of fun things in there and support each other and have a lot of fun. When you join for just $10, I'm going to donate half of that, $5, to Starlight Children's Foundation. It's Children's Cancer Awareness Month, and I wanna help seriously ill children and their families. And Starlight Children's Foundation does just that. Your $5 donation with your meal prep membership will help bring programs to hospitals that help those children live like a kid while they're in the hospital, whether it's video gaming or special pajamas they can wear. Starlight Children's Foundation helps these kids through their treatment in the hospital. So think of it as a fundraiser with meal prep benefits. Just join for $10 and I'm gonna take 5 of it and turn it back into a donation. And I said I was gonna keep scrubbing here, and I'm not. And the other thing is there's no risk involved. So I wanna assure you, this is only $10 for the whole month. So you're gonna get to try 4 weeks of dinners. That's 60 recipes. Actually, it's over 40 recipes because you get the batch recipes too. But if you find at the end of the month it's not for you, you can cancel before you have any charges are incurred. And that's with any time of the year. You can always try us for $10, and if it's not your thing, no hard feelings, you can opt out. But if you join this month, I'll still donate that $5 to Starlight Children's Foundation, and you get some meal prep benefits. So please, 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 if you're even slightly interested in getting a little help with dinner this month, and I know a lot of us working parents could use a little help this month as we're back in school and doing all the things and cooking more than ever with school lunch and breakfast and dinner. If you're even slightly interested, head over to batchcookingclub.com. You'll see it in a big, big letters, all that you need to do to join, and I would be so grateful, and so will Starlight Children's Foundation. All right, enough of my commercial. Back to the mushrooms. So I've got all these mushrooms here. Now, you can store them, you can make this jar, marinated mushrooms, in any kind of, you know, storage container that you like. I especially love mason jars. I just think they're so pretty, and I like to be able to see everything that I have in my refrigerator so I remember to eat it. So I'm actually gonna demonstrate this using a ball mason jar. And you only need a few ingredients for this recipe. You're gonna need olive oil, so it's a fourth a cup of olive oil, to equal amounts of olive oil to equal amounts of balsamic vinegar. We're doing, again, Italian inspired. The great thing about marinating is you can change it up so many different ways. Do you want to use sesame oil and a rice vinegar and make it an Asian-esque kind of thing? Do you want to use red wine vinegar? You know, there's all sorts of different olive oils you could use, blood orange infused vinegars. So many ways you could have fun with this. And the herbs I'm using today are oregano and thyme. I have a half a teaspoon of each. And again, you can change this up. You could do fresh herbs if you wanted. I have a mix here. I'm gonna also add Italian fresh parsley, but you could change up the herbs as well. So you can kind of think of this as like a template that you can then, you know, change up for yourself any other way. Now, in any type of marinade, I've gotta have garlic. I'm gonna put the parsley in here. So I have got, this is a quarter cup of Italian parsley. I've got, four garlic cloves because I honestly feel like life is so much better with garlic. Garlic and avocado, that's all I really need to be a happy girl. Okay, so I'm gonna put my garlic in there. So I put the base of all the marinade ingredients in first. And then a little bit of salt, it's a half a teaspoon. You can adjust salt. I know everyone's kind of has their own preference for salt. I'm gonna do a half a teaspoon. And then you can always go up from there, or you can start less if you want. Okay, and then I'm gonna do a quarter teaspoon of freshly ground pepper. Now we are using, I mentioned, you can use these in a lot of different ways, but we are using this week, I'll tell you a little bit about this week's plan. We drop new plans every Wednesday, so that way you can meal plan. Like I said, I give you four dinner recipes, so you have a few to fill in. So we give you it on Wednesday so that you can either take Thursday and or Friday to fill out the rest of your plan. Head to the store on Friday or Saturday, and then get in the kitchen on Batch Cook Sunday or Saturday and do your meal prep for the week. So this is one of the recipes we're prepping on the weekend to then later turn into a meal next week. And we are turning them into portobello steak and potato kebabs. So these are little, I don't know if you guys knew this, but cremini mushrooms are mini portobellos. So I had a little fun play on words, portobello steak and potato kebabs. So we're marinating the mushrooms and then we're threading them on kebabs with potatoes, and we're pairing it with the Batch Cooking Club steak sauce, which has an Italian spin on it. We use a balsamic reduction. I'm just trying to screw my lid on here. We use a balsamic reduction, rosemary, and sun-dried tomatoes to give it an Italian-themed flavor. So these kebabs really are infused with Italian flavor. So that's one of the recipes on the menu. You get the Italian marinade, steak and potato kebabs and grilled marinated vegetables. That's one of the meals. We also have on this week's meal plan, okay, so I'm sorry, I should show you what I'm doing here. I'm just giving this all a little zhuzh, and then we're gonna add the mushrooms in here, and you wanna let them marinate as long as you can, at least 20 minutes before you eat them, but to an hour, I would say at least an hour. I forget what we say in the recipe, but I would you can do overnight or a few days. The longer they sit, the better they're gonna taste. So again, we make these on the weekend, you have them later in the week, it's all good. So I'm just gonna layer these in here. Okay, so also on the clam is hearts of palm ceviche. That's another batch recipe that we turn into hearts of palm ceviche tostadas and hearts of palm ceviche rice bowls later in the week. So those are one of the things that we do is we double batch. I give you more bang for your batch. So if you're in the kitchen, we want you to be making the most of your time. So while you're in there, make a double batch of hearts of palm ceviche so you can use it two ways. And we're also making easy garlic rice this weekend. A double batch, and we're using it in those ceviche rice bowls, and we're also using them in a new recipe that I'm really excited about called tomato fried rice, and I can't wait to hear what our members think about that. There you go. I'm just gonna give it a little zhuzh. And when you store this in the refrigerator, go in every, you know, day or half a day in the morning when you're getting your green juice or whatever, give it a little shake so that they're constantly marinating. Now the recipe that I gave you could do a little bit more mushrooms. I told you there's about two cups. We could do about another cup in here. You can see there. Well, I don't know how many we could fit in this jar, but you could do that. So you guys, this is how easy these are. They are so good, and I just go and shake it around a little bit. And I let it sit for about 24 hours, but optimally, if I can hold on to myself, not and hold back to before eating, the more days, the better. And like I said, I love, I gave you a few ideas, snack boards, antipasto platters. These are really good in pasta casseroles too. And I love them in salads. You could put them in stir fries. I'm gonna use them in salads all week. This is like my favorite. So that's that. So anyways, back to the menu this week again is your hearts of palm ceviche tostadas, your hearts of palm ceviche rice bowls, your tomato fried rice, and your portobello steak and potato kebabs with grilled marinated vegetables. It's still summer, you guys. Even though the kids are back in school, it's not autumn until the end of September. So we gotta make the most of our grills this next couple weeks. With Labor Day, this is a great recipe to put on the grill on Monday. So anyway, there we go. Do we have any questions or anything? Okay, so then I guess before we close out, I just wanted to invite all of you, if you haven't already, join me over on Instagram and here on Batch Cooking Club on Facebook. We are here sharing lots of meal prep strategies and tips, and you can also join me over at Vegamama, V-E-G-M-A-M-A, which is where I personally live on social media, on Facebook and Instagram, where you can get in touch with me individually. We can talk about meal prep, we can talk about anything you want to talk about. Distance learning with the kids, I'm with you. We all need support right now. So I just want to thank you for watching. We will be back next Thursday. The time is going to be a little later in the afternoon, but we'll still be here on Thursday. And I'll give you a little sneak peek of what we're doing. It's a favorite. I was testing them earlier this week. I made another batch last night. My whole family cannot stop devouring them. Garlic Parmesan fries. Vegan, of course, plant-based. You're gonna love them, and that we're gonna serve them not as a side, but we're gonna serve them in a little different way in a meal. So if you're interested, check out batchcookingclub.com again to join and learn more. Help me raise $500 this month for Starlight Children's Foundation. With every membership, I'm donating $5. So grateful to have you watch. Have a beautiful day, and we'll see you next time.